privilege it is to be with you today.
Qué privilegio estar con ustedes en este día.
Karen and I have been looking forward to coming and celebrating with you 7 years of completing ministry for the Lord Jesus Christ. For the past 19 and a half years,
por los últimos 19 años y medio,
I served as the pastor of the First Baptist Church in Brandon, Florida.
Serví como el pastor de First Baptist Church in Brandon, Florida.
We recently celebrated 100 years of ministry in Florida. And so I say that to encourage you.
Así que le digo eso para animarles.
Some of you may make that 100-year anniversary. Most likely not. But you are establishing a foundation and a ministry that will yield tremendous fruit in the gospel of Jesus Christ until our Lord returns. We want you to know that the Florida Baptist Convention, we want to be right beside you in the vision that God gives you in planting churches and expanding your ministry. We will be partners with you in prayer, in resources, and in whatever way we can come together to reach South Florida for the Lord Jesus Christ. I've had the privilege of getting to know your pastor over the past few months, and I love your pastor. What a vision and a heart he has for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And to answer the call of God, to risk everything, to bring his family, and to believe that God wants him to start something here. And now 7 years later, to come to this celebration and to say all praise, all honor, all glory unto the Lord Jesus Christ, because of obedience to the pastor's heart. So we join with you today in celebration. The body of Christ is about being together. If we're not together, then we'll never reach the purpose for which God established his church. When the Lord blesses his body, he doesn't look upon us as being Hispanic, Haitian, Anglo, Latino. He looks upon us as being believers, as being those who commit our life unto him. And he breaks down every barrier. Nothing separates the body of Christ. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God who is over all. And we commit our lives to him, unto him all. It will take all of us together to reach the world for the Lord Jesus Christ. And so this morning, I want us to revisit a passage of Scripture found in the New Testament, in the book of Acts. It is the very beginnings of the New Testament church. And we find that these are men and women of great faith. As a matter of fact, as you read the book of Acts, you find that by the time you get to Acts chapter 17, they say about the church, the ones who are turning the world upside down are now here with us. And so in a span of 30 years, the book of Acts reveals the expansion of the gospel from Jerusalem to Judea to Samaria and to the ends of the earth. They face the challenges that you face, figuring out what we are to do, understanding our culture, dealing with all the things you must deal with, but yet believing that God has called us, believing that God will use us, believing that God will bless us, believing that God has a purpose for his church. And we come together to accomplish that task. And so we look together at a moment in the life of the church. It is found in the book of Acts, chapter 4, verse 31. I would invite you to open God's word to that place. And if you're able, would you stand in honor of God's word? Acts chapter 4, verse 31. And when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. And they spoke the word of God with boldness. May God bless the reading of his word. You may be seated. The word together is the word from which the Old Testament synagogue is derived. We know about the synagogue. It was the place where they convened. It was where they assembled. It's where they united their lives. It's where they experienced the presence of God. They came together. They came together to worship. They came together to praise. They came together to come under the authority of God's word. And there in the synagogue, the covenant people of God heard the voice of God. And they went forward to serve him. This is the very word that is used in this scripture. Together. Together is a beautiful word. God desires that we are together. Unity is important within the body of Christ. In the Old Testament, in Psalm 133, David declares, "Behold, how pleasant and how good it is for us to dwell together in unity." Together in unity. It's like the oil that flows from the head down upon the beard. The beard of Aaron flowing down upon the hem of his garments. You see, when we come together in unity, the anointing of God falls upon us. All is vain unless the Holy Spirit moves in our midst. But we can quench the Holy Spirit of God. We can stifle the moving of God if we are not together. But when we are together, the very blessings of heaven flow down upon us. Just like the oil fell upon the priest Aaron, over his head, down upon his beard, down the hem of his garment. And those who were together received that anointing from God, the blessing of God. Oh, there's something about being together, being unified as one. Over 7 years, you have met in different places, but yet what knitted you together was the Lord Jesus Christ. Even now, you have multiple campuses, but what holds you together is the Lord Jesus Christ. And how pleasant it is, how good it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. You see, when the people of God come together, when the people of God come together, when we come together, look out, world, because we are the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Christ said of his church that the gates of hell cannot prevail against us. We must come together, unified. And when the people of God come together, God shows up.
Entonces ahí se manifiesta.
And God blesses.
Y Dios bendice.
And God uses all of our lives. He uses you. He uses you. He uses you. He uses you. And together, for His glory, we can do great things in His name. For there is nothing that is impossible with God. Together, unified. When the people of God come together, when we seek the Lord together, when we do the work of the Lord together, the hand of God blesses the work of the church. And so this morning, I want to encourage you. I want to challenge you to hear what the Spirit will say in your heart. Are you together? Are you committed to what God has called us to be committed to? Are you committed to the Lord first and foremost? And committed to His church? This church, Turning Point Church, that God has led you to be a part of, to invest your life, to invest your resources, to invest your time, to invest your talents. And what we do together, God will use to His glory. And so this morning, I want the Spirit of God to speak to me. I want to be together for the gospel. I want the church to be together for the Lord Jesus Christ. You see, there may be things in your heart today that are keeping you from being together. Power, position, prestige, thinking I'm more important than someone else, thinking that nobody's listening to me, when we need to be listening to the Lord Himself. We need to be hearing the voice of God and saying, Lord, this is your church, and we are your people, we are your children, we are your servants, and nothing that we do can have an impact in the world unless we are together in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so this morning, let's look and read about the church being together. When they were assembled together, they began to pray. They were together in prayer. Now, I don't think this is just some little simple prayer. This wasn't just praying because we ought to pray. Man, these people are on their face before God. They're emptying their hearts before the Holy One. They are repenting of sin. They are repenting of their arrogance. They're repenting of their greed. They're repenting of anything in their life that keeps them from being used of God. And together, they are in prayer. You see, for the church to go forward, we must be together in prayer. There is no significant moving of God that we find within the Scripture or that we find in Christian history that did not begin in prayer. Are we seeking the face of God? Are we praying together? Lord, what do you require of me? Lord, what are you asking of me? Lord, what am I holding back that you desire? Lord, what am I keeping from you that you want? Lord, what of my life is a hindrance to the Holy Spirit of God? Together, we need to get on our face before God. And we need to cry out unto God in repentance unto Him. And say, Lord, whatever it takes, and whatever you ask, I am committed to you. In prayer.
En oración.
We must trust the Lord.
Tenemos que confiar en el Señor.
7 years ago,
hace 7 años,
that journey of prayer to trust began.
Nada de confiar en oración comenzó.
Oh, it didn't start the first day the church met.
Y ahí, el primer día que se unió.
Prayer began long before that. And God began stirring in the heart of Noel and his family. God began stirring in the hearts of others. And in unity together, just like the oil that fell upon the head, and down upon the beard, and down to the hem, now that oil flows among the hearts of many, many people. And we must continue to pray. We must continue to see. We must continue to trust. For while we celebrate today, today is not about completion. Today is about the future. And what God still desires to do through His church. Do we pray in that fashion? Earnestly seeking the Lord. Oh, if my people who are called by my name will turn from their wicked ways, if they will seek my face, then will I hear from heaven. Then will I bless through prayer. Oh, aren't we grateful for the beautiful promise of Scripture that if we confess our sin, then He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sin, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So you see, prayer isn't just some little church thing. Prayer is speaking to the God of the universe, who cares about you, who created you, who has called you unto Himself, who gave His precious Son to die upon a cross, taking your sins upon Himself. And Jesus cried out, "It is finished." He completed salvation's work. And they placed Him in the grave. And on the third day, Jesus burst forth unto life. And He ascended to God the Father in heaven, where at this very moment, He is at the right hand of the Father. Our high priest, our advocate with the Father, our intercessor, who brings the sweet smelling savor of the prayers of God's people into the presence of the Father. We must be together in prayer. When they were assembled together, the place where they were together was shaken. They prayed, and they found the very presence of God, the presence of the Lord. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. That's not a typical day at church. That's the day that the bulletins put aside. That's the day that the singers aren't even sure what to sing. That's the day the preacher doesn't even know what to preach. That's the day the worshipers aren't even sure what's going on, because God has fallen in our midst. And we are here just to worship Him, to praise Him, to honor Him, to magnify Him, to glorify Him in everything that we do. The presence of God. When was the last time that you experienced just the manifold presence of Almighty God, where God showed up in a big way in the midst of your life, in the midst of your prayers, in the midst of your journey in the Word, in the midst of your service, in the midst of everything in your life, shaken by the presence of God? 7 years later,
7 años después,
we are here today
estamos aquí hoy
because the place is shaken.
Porque ese lugar de oración inicial.
And God's will is being lived out
y Dios ha cumplido
by those
who
are willing to come
en aquellos que han dispuesto a unirse.
Now we're all Baptists here.
Todos somos bautistas aquí.
I guess.
Pienso.
We're all believers here.
Todos somos creyentes.
I've been around Baptist churches all
yo
of my life.
Iglesia bautista toda mi vida.
I grew up in North Alabama.
Yo fui criado en el norte de Alabama.
I have a little bit of an accent.
Tengo
you can tell.
Un acento guajiro todavía.
In a little country church.
En una iglesia de campo.
Every Sunday.
Cada domingo.
We sang three hymns.
Ahí cantábamos tres hymns.
We had the announcements.
Y entonces los anuncios.
We sang another hymn. We took up the offering. The choir did a special. The preacher preached. They gave the invitation. And we went home. And that's going to happen no matter what. Every Sunday. You see, we have to guard ourselves. Because we can get so good at what we do that we forget God's presence isn't upon him. It's just of the flesh. And the church is not of the flesh. We are of the Spirit. This is a supernatural body of believers. And we serve a God of great miracles. And his miracles have not ceased. His presence has not departed. He is with us. And may we come together in unity, assembled as one, in such a way that every time the people of God gather, the place is shaken by the Holy Spirit. To gather in prayer, to gather in presence, but also to gather in purpose. When they had prayed, the place where they were together assembled was shaken. And the Holy Spirit filled them all. And so they said, boy, this has been fun. I love this. Let's say amen and go home and say nothing about what God has done. No. Look to what the word says. They spoke the word of God with boldness. With boldness. If we're going to push back the darkness of this world, if we're going to reach South Florida, if we're going to reach Florida, if we're going to reach the United States, if we're going to take the gospel to the ends of the earth, God's people have got to stand up, speak up, and testify of the great things that he has done. We will speak the word. There are times I'm intimidated. There are times when I walk away from a conversation and the Holy Spirit just convicts me. Why didn't you say something to that person? Why didn't you use this opportunity that I gave you to speak the name of Jesus Christ? To be in a setting and to hear all the clatter of the world and allow it to silence the gospel. Oh, the church.
Oh, iglesia.
This church.
Esta iglesia.
They spoke the word with boldness.
Ellos hablaron la palabra con denuedo.
Now, what did this cost them? What did this cost them?
¿Qué les costó a ellos?
If you just keep reading on, just in the next chapter or so,
ustedes verán los próximos capítulos.
You will find that they were put in prison.
Vas a encontrar que los pusieron en la cárcel.
Because they spoke the word boldness.
That'll
shut the church up, won't it?
Eso a veces cae a la iglesia.
That'll keep us quiet, won't it?
Eso realmente para.
While they were in prison,
pero mientras estaban en
they just spoke the word even in a bolder way.
Hablando la palabra con más de nuevo.
And so the authorities said, what are we going to do?
Así que aquellos en la autoridad dijeron,
They're speaking here. They're speaking there. We can't shut them up. So we're going to bring them out and we're going to beat them publicly. And if everybody sees the cost of speaking the name of Jesus Christ, then that has stopped this. And so they brought them out publicly and they beat them. And they told them, no more. Be quiet. Don't say anything else. And they let them go. And the very next thing that they did was that they assembled themselves together. And they spoke the word of God with boldness. We must together understand the purpose for which we have been redeemed. The purpose for which the church exists. And that is to make the name and the fame of Jesus Christ published to all the nations, to the ends of the earth. And we have that responsibility here. Here to publish the good tidings of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Together. It's a powerful word, isn't it? Oh, God can do anything with any person. He doesn't need all of us. But he chooses to use us. It's a blessing from God. He could take one of us and do what all of us together collectively could accomplish. But yet God chooses to work through each person who calls upon his name. And so this morning, as we draw this teaching to a conclusion, together,
juntos.
I think on our screen you're going to see
a
picture of together.
Un retrato de juntos.
When I read about heaven,
cuando yo veo del cielo,
I read about together.
Yo leo acerca de unidos.
They were gathered from every tribe,
de cada tribu,
from every tongue,
de cada lengua y idioma,
and from every nation.
Y en cada nación.
Together.
Ahí están juntos.
Unified in
unidos
Christ.
En Cristo.
The things that we allow to separate us must melt away under the Holy Spirit of God. And we must come together. And so this morning, at a time of 7-year celebration, I'm speaking to you to come together. To come together. In a moment, team will begin playing and singing. And I'm going to ask you to come together. Just as we see the beautiful linking of hands and hearts, for you to come together. Fill this front together. Hands together. Arms together. Hearts together. Minds together. Lives together. To do what God wants us to do. And to pray, Lord, when we're together, shake us that we would go forward to speak the word of God
with
great boldness. You see, this morning, some need to come together for prayer. Maybe you're hurting today. There are great struggles going on in your life, in your family,
in
your marriage, in your job, health issues, financial issues, relationship issues, sin issues. And today, together, we want to come to pray and seek the Lord. Together, and those need to come and say, I just need that fresh touch from God in my life. Oh, I know I'm saved. I know that Jesus Christ is my Lord. But I know I've not been committed to him the way that I need to be. My life is not reflecting that relationship with Christ. And so let's come together to say we want to seek the presence of the Lord.
A
fresh touch upon my life today. Fresh oil. Fresh fire. Fresh wind. Move upon my life. The presence of the Lord. some who say today, I need to come together and commit myself again to God's purposes. I've not been speaking the word of God boldly. I've not been sharing Christ with my family, with my friends, with my neighbors. I've been silently serving the Savior. And I need that boldness in my life. And we're encouraged together to be bold within our faith and to speak that word with great boldness. So we're just going to ask you to come at this altar. We're going to pray in a moment as you come. Just come and stay right here. Come and stay right here. Linking hands, arms, hearts together. Now as some are moving, there are others who are here today who have never trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And this morning, you know that you need to make a salvation decision. You need to come and trust Jesus Christ as your Savior. There are stairs on each side of this platform. And I would ask you just to come to those stairs. And we will meet you right there. And we're going to talk to you today about what it means to know Jesus Christ. Just going to ask you to come on. Let's just gather together. Move on down. Just fill this truck together. Come, holding heart. No one up the aisle. Just make our way. Fill across the front right here. As they sing for a few moments, let's pray. Let's pray. Pray within your heart. Call upon the Lord. Whatever He is asking you to do, do it right now. In this moment of prayer, together. And as we pray, and as we praise the Lord, He will shake this place. He will shake this moment. We'll never be the same. Because we have assembled together. God is going to move us out to the next 7 years and beyond with an exciting future for the gospel of Jesus Christ. So join hearts, join hands. Let's pray.
Sweet above.
queremos orar específicamente sobre este momento.
Some of you came here because you just needed that as a prayer. And Lord, we pray now for your healing touch upon lives, for homes that are broken, for marriages that are struggling, for children that are rebelling, for the struggles that are pressing against us. Father, I pray today for a fresh touch within our families. I pray that even now marriages will be restored. Father, that those prodigals would come home. That your healing touch will come upon lives. Father, I pray now for those who come, who are just confessing things within their life. We're praying for that fresh touch upon them. I pray that you renew a right spirit, a clean heart, a pure heart, holy hands, a holy touch, and lives be renewed before you today. And I pray for the church today. Such an amazing future. And I pray, Lord, that we'll commit to going forward with boldness in the gospel. Lord, you continue to do great and mighty things through your church, Turning Point Church. And now I want to ask you if you would, for everyone to turn and look this way. And I'm going to pray for our pastor today. I want you just to stretch your hands before the stage. Father, I thank you for this servant. You have called him unto yourself. You have saved him through your blood. You have called him by your Holy Spirit. And you have put a clear vision in his heart. He has been willing to go to a land that he didn't know where it would lead. But by faith he has followed. And through the highs and the lows, and through the ups and downs, Lord, you have been faithful, and he has been faithful. And we praise you for that today. I thank you for all that you have brought around this vision, who believe in what you have called this church to do. Father, I pray that you'll encourage his pastor, his precious wife. We pray for him today. We know his heart is burdened over his father. We pray that you'll encourage him. We pray for your protection, even over his father. That angels would attend to him. That mercy and grace would fall upon his life. Father, I pray that you'll renew your pastor. Lord, as he moves forward, there will be a fire within him that nothing can quench. There will be a fresh word from you that he will proclaim from this pulpit. That there will be leadership and vision, and he will see things he's never seen before that only you can lead him to do. And I pray, Father, your anointing upon his life, that the oil would flow from his head, down upon his face, down upon his garment, and as it flows off the hem of his garment, that together in unity the church would rise up, and that we would glorify the name above every name, the name of Jesus.